The FGM-148 Javelin is America's premier man-portable, fire-and-forget anti-tank system. This system was fielded as an improvement over the M47 Dragon anti-tank system. Since its deployment, Javelin has proved to be the U.S. military's most effective man-portable weapon system. U.S. Marines and Army personnel are equipped with these, especially the frontline infantry squads. Javelins have been exported to NATO countries as well as to allies like Saudi Arabia and Australia, to name a few. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russia should fear America's Javelin anti-tank missile. Javelin's development started during the Cold War era in the 70s and 80s when U.S. military strategists dreaded that vast Soviet tank forces could overrun the U.S. and its allies in land battles. The M47 Dragon anti-tank missile available to U.S. military at that time was not very dependable, and this led to efforts to develop a completely new system. The Javelin finally entered service with the U.S. military in 1996, but by then the Soviet Union had collapsed. Eventually, Javelin was first deployed and used in 2003 during the U.S. invasion of Iraq. Javelin basically has two parts, a launcher which has the targeting systems and the missiles which has the warhead. The launcher has a high-tech infrared sensor with multiple viewing modes, including 4x optical zoom, a 4x green-lit thermal view, and a 12x narrow vision zoom activated for targeting. Javelin's targeting system is different than the Dragon as it uses the infrared guidance instead of wired guidance. This has a major advantage as the user can take cover immediately after launch. The system, loaded with missile, weighs in at 50 pounds or 23 kilograms, doesn't require any tripod, and can be fired from a crouch or even seated position. Being relatively light and compact, they're generally carried inside armored vehicles. The system has small backblast and hence can be fired from confined spaces. These characteristics make Javelin very versatile. Raytheon and Lockheed Martin are responsible for manufacturing it. Unlike the Dragon, the Javelin has been proven to be very effective. For example, in the Battle of Debeka Pass in Iraq, a force of a few dozen Special Forces operators, having just 4 Javelin launchers, destroyed mechanized company of over 100 soldiers. 17 of the 19 missiles that were fired found their targets and destroyed 2 T-55 tanks, 8 MTLB armored personnel carriers, and several trucks. Since its ability to impact a land battle scenario is so well proven, the sales of Javelin have become a political issue. For instance, when the Trump administration approved a plan to provide this lethal weapon to Ukraine recently, Russia responded angrily. Viewers may note here that Russian tanks supporting the separatists in Ukraine were instrumental in driving the Ukrainian government forces in the back foot. The Javelin's 127mm shaped charge warhead can penetrate about 600 to 800mm of rolled hardened armor. With this kind of power, Javelin will fail to penetrate a decent modern tank's armor, but Javelin has a trick up its sleeves. What it lacks in power, it makes up in tactic. The Javelin has a unique mode, the top attack mode, by which it doesn't hit the frontal or side armor of a tank, but it targets the top armor, which tends to be much thinner. The missile has gyroscopes and gimbals that enable it to nosedive almost vertically onto the infrared signature it was locked onto. Many tanks have explosive reactive armor, ERA, to defeat this. ERA is designed to prematurely ignite the shaped charges used by missiles and disperses the explosive power away from the tank. But Javelin overcomes this defense measure by using tandem charge warhead, which has a pre-charge that takes out the ERA layer before the main charge is engaged. Javelin can be fired in normal straight attack mode too. This is useful against bunker or cave entrants, which have strong top cover. This mode is also effective against low-flying helicopters. The potent capability of Javelin has not gone unnoticed. Russia's latest tanks have some countermeasures to defeat Javelin, but their effectiveness is suspect. Number one, newly developed systems like Relict and Mechanit ERA have dual layers of radar-triggered ERA plates designed specifically to defeat tandem charge warheads. The problem with this method is that the radar may not always pick up the incoming missile. Also, the dual layer plates make the tanks even more heavy, impacting mobility to an extent. Number two, the Shitora and the latest Afghanit active protection systems can deploy soft kill grenades and flares. These are designed to obscure the tank from infrared seekers by forming a haze surrounding the tank or confuse them with other heat sources. But Javelin's infrared sensor is very advanced and can separate target from obscuring haze and flares. Number 3. Hard kill defense of Afghanit system on Russia's latest T-14 tank aims to shoot incoming missiles down with its own warhead. But as seen in the design, the tubes that will fire this defensive warhead are angled horizontally and will not be able to take out Javelin, which plunges at almost 90 degree angle. Javelin is in its path to have a four-fold upgrade to meet future threats. 1. As tank armor improves, Javelin is also stepping up the game. A new variant, designated the FGM-148F, has been developed that has a deadlier blast fragmentation warhead. Number 2. In an effort to make the system even more compact, a lightweight launcher is being developed. The new launcher is expected to be 70% smaller and weigh almost half as much. This will make it easier to carry and fire from almost anywhere. Number 3. One of the major drawbacks of the current Javelin is its limited range of 2.5 kilometers. To mitigate this, Javelin is being upgraded to have capacity of hitting targets up to 4.5 kilometers away. And number 4. For better target identification, a new laser pointer with upgraded electronics, an HD camera, and superior IR sensor will be introduced.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.